Lovely. So let's try right into head voice. The beautiful. Lovely. So let's lift. Make sure it's a nice because the ooh will lift the soft palate. Okay. Beautiful. Lovely. Then where you feel, because at the moment that's all in head, it's beautiful. So I switched it then from head into mixed down into chest. Really nice, that's beautiful control. Beautiful. That's it, and now you are definitely that switching into kind of mixed register, but don't start off ooh, heavy. Ooh, still keep it nice and light for the blending. Ooh, beautiful. That was really expressive as well, it's lovely. Yeah, I didn't expect. Ooh, nice. You can hear your natural vibrato coming into it, it's really lovely. Singing that just then was absolutely beautiful, like we said about your mouth shape.
Okay.
So that's been a little revelation for you, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Do you think sometimes it was like how it was explained, but for you now to know that your jaw, you can literally go, Titania! And just let it go, drop down and back and have your tongue behind your bottom teeth.
Yeah, and just like, I know this sounds weird, but this really is something new to me. And at the same, like normally in my breath training,
mm-hmm.
I think like this thing like the upper lip.
Yes.
Just cover the upper lip should cover your teeth.
Also. Okay.
Mm-hmm. That maybe somehow like that. It's just like you open your mouth, so at least you can show teeth. Of course. But try not to show that one because feel like it will leak too much air, things like that.
There's differences because there's differences in if you're doing classical and you've got the sound resonating at the back of your head.
Okay.
You'll have the lift and the resonation at the back of the head to produce that kind of very classical where you get the sound resonating quite plummy sound. Whereas with pop, we want to, so you bring the sound forward, and part of opening up and making the sound come forward is you're making it fill these air pockets, and to do that as well, as you see when you see rock and pop stars singing, you bring the air into the front of the face, and you use the teeth and use the tongue, so it's actually different vocal styles, so there's kind of like,
But how different from, I think there should be a conception of mask. I think you know what I'm talking. I don't know what it is in English. I think it's a conception for mask in the classic singing as well.
That's right.
So where are the difference?
So with the classical singing, the air, you feel it sort of resonate and hit the back of the head more. So this kind of... Of course, it's still vibrating a bit in your mask, but it's mainly... You feel it here, whereas when you're singing like forward place pop, you're bringing the sound really, 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 really forward by use of like the teeth, all of this. And you can use both of them at the same, you can use them as something in certain songs, when you're singing it really high, you might not just want da, which can be quite aggressive. So you have ti. So I've actually got forward place here with a little bit of lift as well. And that's very advanced technique. When you you feel your body really well, and you understand what it feels like to have you forward, you understand what it's like to be classical, and then you learn the position, the muscle. I know that gives a lift, but it's got power, sound, so you learn the muscle memory to do it. Okay. And you were doing in titanium just then.
Okay.
You were making, that's phenomenally difficult. You were singing that in pitch, as written, for a woman, and you were using the titanium. You're using a little bit of the classical and the forward placement to hit the high notes. It's really great. Okay. Yeah. It's huge.
You didn't feel it by yourself.
But you've, over the last few months, really worked on getting so that you can have this choice of how you want to use your voice, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
It's really exciting, because it's going to be exciting when you go back home.
Must be.
About how how people are going to hear your voice as well. But you use all these techniques and then you decide on how you want to sound it. And as long as you're using, it's never on the throat, never hurting the throat, ever, ever. It doesn't even feel like, you don't even feel your throat scratch, ever. There's never, it's just how you use the positioning and the air will change the sound. So it's always, when I was doing that, doesn't hurt my throat because I'm using support from here.
But I think we didn't push forward to push the force to throat.
That's right.
But anyway, we still need to use it. I think that's right.
Absolutely. And you never do. You open up beautiful now. Okay. It's really lovely. And you can hear when people push from the throat. It's I don't like demonstrate. It's quite horrible. It's very you get a very tight, horrid sound, and it hurts instantly. Yeah. The thing is, like anything, if it hurts, you shouldn't do it. It's that simple. Like, absolutely not, because you're doing something.
Yeah,
sometimes you might do vocal fry where you have a little a little growl, but you only use it like in rock songs. You might occasionally use a little vocal fry, but it's you try not to use it that much. So that was cool. So thanks for that. Thanks for that little chat, Ted.